Here are just some of the many things that happened this past week in New Hanover County government. About 2,800 New Hanover County residents have cast their primary ballots during the first full week of absentee one-stop voting. Voting sites are at the New Hanover County Government Center, the Downtown and Northeast Libraries, and at the New Hanover County Senior Resource Center. Early voting continues through May 5th. The New Hanover County television crew and New Hanover County Fire Service staff paid a visit to the North Carolina Aquarium at Fort Fisher this week. We're in the process of creating a new awareness campaign leading up to the swimming season. New Hanover County Commission Chairman Ted Davis Jr. recognized 8-year-old Seth Blizzard as a 911 hero on Wednesday. Seth was able to recognize that his grandmother was choking, called 911, and followed the telecommunicator's instructions on how to perform the Heimlich maneuver. The award was presented in front of Seth's classmates at Eaton Elementary School. Also Wednesday, the 8th annual Flower Launch recognized those who work to protect children against abuse. The event on the Cape Fear River also featured recognition of Dr. Sonia Shanley, the medical director of the Carousel Center. Dr. Shanley's work has led to the successful indictment and prosecution of child abusers in southeastern North Carolina. Roses are one of the topics covered in the May issue of the Coastal Gardener. Host Al Height of the New Hanover County Cooperative Extension also talks lawn care and garden guru myth-busting. You can watch the Coastal Gardener during the month of May here on NHC TV. New Hanover County health officials and law enforcement are helping kids stay safer while crossing streets and riding bicycles. The Health Department's Safe Kids Coalition worked with the City of Wilmington and others to improve the crossing signals at 8th and 10th and Castle Streets, while deputies and police gave children bicycle helmets and other safety tips. And New Hanover County landfill personnel are helping a Wilmington builder create the area's first biodiesel fueling station. Old School Rebuilders is pulling lumber and other products thrown away by the building industry. The lumber and other stuff will be reused in the building that'll house a 1,000-gallon biodiesel fuel tank next door to the Tidal Creek Co-op on Oleander Drive. Those were just some of the events in New Hanover County government this past week. Got a question? Visit our website, www.nhcgov.com. You can also follow us on Twitter and fan us on Facebook. We're here to serve you. Thanks for watching.